Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing really well today. So I am really excited today because I have a fabric haul for you guys for all of the fall fabrics that I've recently added to my fabric collection. I also have some yarn, so I thought today I would just talk through all of my plans for fall sewing projects and knitting projects. And the weather has actually cooperated today. It's pretty cloudy and rainy and fall-like, so I'm really excited about that. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump in and show you guys all the different fabrics. They are from some different places, so I'll go through all of the different shops I got them from and show you what I found. So let's start out with a few fabrics from Joann Fabrics. I recently went to Joann Fabrics looking for one specific fabric, and that was the one that I was not able to find, but I found three that I wasn't planning to get. So let me show you those to you. The first one is this really beautiful rose color double gauze, and they've recently started carrying double gauze at Joann Fabrics, and the fall colors that they have are so beautiful. They have this rose color as well as a really dark rust color that I really liked, but this is the one that I ended up getting, and it's just such a lovely fabric. It has such a nice texture, which I really love. So for this fabric, I'm thinking of making a Peter Pan collar long sleeve blouse. I really need more fall appropriate blouses in my wardrobe for work, so that is what I'm thinking of this. And recently I've started seeing different Peter Pan collar style blouses out and about, and that just makes me so happy. I was so into those back when I was in college. If you knew me in college, I was always wearing Peter Pan collars. So I'm excited to have the excuse to add a Peter Pan collar to my wardrobe. This next fabric is the most beautiful rust corduroy, and it's such good quality. It's the really tiny corduroy, and I love the texture and the sheen on this fabric. It's coming up a little more orange on camera. I would say it's a little bit more red toned in real life, but I think it is so, so beautiful. So I'm not 100% sure what I want to do with this one yet. I was looking on the Madewell website and they had several pieces made in a really similar corduroy, so I'm taking those as inspiration. One was a little smock style dress and the other was a pair of trousers, so I'm kind of leaning towards trousers, but let me know what you guys think, and I will definitely share in a future video. And then the last fabric that I got from Joann Fabrics is this beautiful brushed cotton in a houndstooth pattern. The colors are kind of like a rust and brown and tan, and I think this is so, so pretty. It's probably a little bit hard to see, but I'll try to include a close-up as well. And I'm planning to make a pair of trousers out of this fabric. I think it will be really, really cute and a versatile piece to add to my fall wardrobe, something that will go really well with plain colored sweaters. So I'm excited about this one, and it's so soft too. So this next fabric is a linen floral fabric from Merely Susan. I talked about her shop a lot this summer, and I definitely wanted to get a different floral fabric for the fall season. So this one is a cream linen with the most beautiful rose print on it. I absolutely love this one. This was actually the first fabric of hers that I had found, but it was out of stock when I was looking at her shop this summer, so I was so excited when she restocked it. I think it's so beautiful. So I am planning to make a dress out of this fabric, and for this dress, I'm planning to use the Stitch Witch Patterns Basque dress, which is so lovely. It has a basque waist and the prettiest sleeves. So I'll put a picture in here so you guys can see what that pattern looks like, but I'm really excited to get started on this project. This will be an early fall project for me because this is the type of thing that I can still wear in the early fall where I live. It will probably be a little bit cool for the later fall months though. And then the last couple of fabrics that I have are from Mood Fabrics. I bought these during their recent Labor Day sale. I try to watch out for the different seasonal sales with fabric shops, and I think that one was 20% off. So just keep that in mind if you're looking for fabric in the future. But the first one is a white dotted Swiss cotton. And I've really been wanting to try out making a Victorian inspired blouse with some lace insertion details. So that is what I'm planning to do with this cotton fabric. I've been looking at a few different blouses from places like Reformation and Cezanne. I don't have a pattern in mind for this style yet, but I think it's going to be really beautiful and something that will pair nicely with fall trousers or jeans and just make it a little bit more feminine. So I'm excited to try this one out. And then this last fabric from Mood Fabrics is a beautiful silk chiffon by Zimmermann. And it's kind of hard to see, but it's actually so, so thin and delicate that the pattern is almost invisible. It's so beautiful and sheer. It has this wisteria print on it, and I really loved the colors of this for fall. And as I was looking up this fabric, I did find the original dress from Zimmermann that is made from this fabric, and that dress was $1,200. It just blows my mind that you can find the exact same fabric as these expensive pieces of clothing. But anyway, I'm planning to make a dress out of this fabric, and for this dress, I'll be using the Apolline Patterns Justine dress pattern, which I think is so lovely. It has these cool ruffle details on the shoulder. So that is the idea for this one, and I hope it'll be a really cute, versatile fall dress. I could see this looking really pretty with brown accessories, like brown boots, so we'll see how it turns out. I do have two more sewing projects in mind that I don't yet have the fabric for, so I thought I'd tell you a little bit about those. One is for a plaid dress with a bow at the neckline, inspired by a dress by Gal Meets Glam that I really liked back when that line was out, but I never got my hands on, so I want to try making my own version of that dress. And I have found a fabric that I think will work for this. It's actually in stock at a small local sewing shop that I haven't been to, so I'm going to go check that out in the next couple of weeks and hopefully get that fabric. It's just a gray plaid fabric, and I think that will be really, really cute. And then along the same lines with the plaid fabric, I also want to make a waxed cotton jacket out of some plaid fabric this fall. I saw one on the Madewell website that I thought was so cute, and I think it's the kind of thing I'll get a lot of use out of where I live because it does rain quite a lot in the fall. So I want to try my hand at weatherproofing something, so that is on my list as well. I'm not sure if I'll use the same fabric for both of these because they are both gray plaid cotton, so I technically could, so I'll just see what I can find, but both of those are also on my list. And then moving on to knitting projects, I've actually gotten started on one for the fall already over the last couple of weeks, and this is what it looks like so far. This is sweater number 15 from My Favorite Things Knitwear, and I just had a lot of scrap cream colored yarn, so I thought it would be a really classic piece just to make a simple cable knit sweater out of it. So this is the back, how far I've gotten on it so far while I've been watching TV recently. So this is my first knitting project for the fall. I just wanted to try my hand at doing a cable knit sweater. I love cable designs, so this is what I've got so far. And then I have a bag here of yarn that I've purchased recently, so let me show you what's in here and what I have planned for all of this. I recently saw a sweater on Instagram that is actually a Chanel sweater, so obviously way out of my budget, but I thought it looked like it'd be a pretty easy knitting project to make, so I found this yarn, which is a mohair and merino, and it has such a beautiful sheen to it, so I am planning to make something kind of inspired by this Chanel sweater. It is a chunky knit with this collar detail, and I'm not sure if I'll make the collar attached or make a detachable collar, just so it's a little bit more versatile if that trend goes out of fashion, but I think this yarn is such a beautiful rose color, and I'm really excited about that project. And then finally, I'm not sure when this project will get done, but I know I've mentioned it before, I am still planning to try and figure out that Love Shack fancy sweater with the floral detailing. I've had to go through a couple of different iterations with the yarn because the yarns that I had were not quite working, so I've ended up going for a smaller merino wool yarn, and I think this will work a lot better with the color work, so I'm still in the experiment phase on this one, but hopefully it will get figured out over the next few months, and I will definitely update you guys. So that is it for all of my fall sewing and knitting plans. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing all of these fabrics. I will try to link to everything down below in case you'd like to check it out for yourselves. But thank you guys so much for watching today. I would love to know what you are planning to make over the next few months. I just love crafting during this time of year. I think it's probably my favorite time of year for sewing and knitting. It just feels like the best cozy activity. So I'm really looking forward to getting started on all of these, and I'll definitely take you along for all of these projects. Thank you guys so much for watching and spending your time here on my channel today. If you are new around here, you can go ahead and subscribe by clicking the red button down below if you're interested, and I would really appreciate it. And if you'd like to keep up with me outside of YouTube, TikTok and Instagram are always linked down below in case you'd like to check them out as well. But thank you again for spending your time here on my channel today. I'm really excited for all of this cozy fall crafting, and I look forward to sharing it with you guys soon, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!